Howdy, friends. My name is Duke, and I'm here to curate some content for you. I just got done watching one of my favorite streamers on Twitch. It's a guy named Jeff Green. Been a fan of his since about 2007 or 2008, back when he was the host of a podcast called the Computer Gaming World Podcast, or CGW for short. He started streaming and stuff relatively recently. He just finished Dark Souls 2. Well, he didn't finish it. He needs to go back and do the DLC and stuff, but he got the ending of the game with credits and everything. It was quite exciting. I hosted it on my channel. I didn't realize until recently that anyone can host another channel on Twitch. I thought you had to be like a Twitch partner or something like that. But no, I can just type /host in the chat room and then their username, and theoretically, you know, if a bunch of people I know want to watch a stream, then I can host it and we can have our own private little chat room for it and be neat. I don't know. I'm fascinated with the Dark Souls games. I tried playing Dark Souls 1 and I did not make it very far, but I think they're pretty fascinating games nonetheless. Anyway, I have not played Rebirth since the last stream. I did not have a very successful stream last time. I'm trying to fill out my normal run icons here. The icons on the left that I explained in the last stream, corresponding to which bosses you beat with which characters. I tried some Keen runs, and I tried some Lazarus runs. Let's go with Lazarus, because last time I went for the Dark Room on every run, and I was not very successful. So, let's try the chest. It's still pretty hard, but it's a little easier than the Dark Room. Oh, hey, Sarah the Lich, what's up? Yes, it has been a while. Well, it's been a while since I streamed. I pretty much took December off. Well, this is a fine how do you do. Alright, if this is a bad item, I'm restarting this run because I hate the dark levels and I'm a pansy. Okay, yeah, it's just a quarter. It's not worth finishing this run for. I probably have better luck than you in Dark Souls. Well, I don't know. Ooh! Splunker hat. That's a pretty good first item to get. It essentially guarantees that I will be able to get every secret room in this whole run, which should be quite helpful. Like, I really enjoy the combat in Dark Souls, like the slow, methodical kind of, you know, thinking man's action RPG. You know, you can't just mash buttons in that game, or you'll die pretty quickly. Very cool combat. My problem with Dark Souls. Oh wait, I guess the secret doors aren't open with this item. I just know where they are. So I still have to use bombs to get there, but they're revealed on the map. See, I was thinking of the X-ray glasses, which are way better. With those, the secret doors are just constantly open. Video keeps buffering. Damn. I don't think it's on my end. Let me Yeah, it's not saying I'm dropping any frames or anything, so I mean, Twitch has been under pretty heavy load recently because of Awesome Games Done Quick, so it might be related to that. I don't know. Hope it clears up for you. But anyway, my problem with the Dark Souls games is figuring out what the heck I'm supposed to be doing. Because I'm not someone who likes to just read a walkthrough and do exactly what it tells me to. You know, I don't get a lot of enjoyment from playing a game that way, which is why I'm a big fan of watching people play Dark Souls 1 and 2, because I get to experience the game vicariously through them. It's more fun than just reading a walkthrough and doing everything it tells me to do would be. died right in the beginning by falling in Dark Souls 2. Yeah, that's a pretty common experience, I think. Sorry. And I mean, you guys know me. I love games where you die a lot. That's why I play this and why I play Spelunky. So that's not the issue for me. I'm fine with dying over and over again and, beating my head against the wall until I finally get it. You know, I'm fine with those kinds of games. Dang it. It's just with Dark Souls, I literally have no idea what I'm supposed to be doing most of the time. So I'm a big fan of Jeff Green's Dark Souls playthroughs. He's on YouTube and Twitch, obviously. Yeah, his username is Greenspeak, if any of you want to look him up. And all of his Dark Souls 1 and 2 playthroughs are on YouTube. Privacy's video is buffering. Dang. Is anyone else watching? Aferol, Sterile Prophet, are either of you having issues? Because if so, I can lower the bitrate on my end and see if that helps. Although this is a bitrate I always stream at, and I'm not downloading or uploading anything. So, well, let me double check and make sure Steam isn't doing something goofy behind the scenes here. I have an update queued for Shovel Knight. It's not actually downloading anything. Yeah, it's everything looks good. So yeah, everyone else in the chat, let me know if you're having issues and I can try. I really hate doing that though, because I already started this video and I don't want to, have to break it up for the YouTube. No issues here, says Sterile Prophet. I think it is Twitch. Yeah, probably. Sorry. I wish there was something I could do. Nice! I wasn't sure that would work on Pin or not, because I wasn't sure if he was technically on the ground, but it worked quite well. No keys, don't want to do the spike room, so I'm done. Yeah, Jeff Green, and there's another Dark Souls streamer, or she doesn't stream, she just makes YouTubes. Oh god, oh okay, I was worried this thing would blow up and hit me. But the series is just called K Plays Dark Souls, K-A-Y, and she's actually really good at the game. Jeff Green is it's inspirational watching him, because he's not good at the game, but he perseveres and he keeps trying, and eventually he succeeds. So it's a nice inspirational message. And of course, as someone who's also not good at video games, I can really relate to his style of gameplay. He does a lot of silly stuff in retrospect, and he has trouble playing and talking at the same time, but he's funny and he has heart, so what more can you ask for? Let's see, I wish there was a way I could bomb the secret room and get that chest. Probably not likely though. How is my HUD off the playing area? I don't know. Oh, you mean how it's like outside the room? I think it's just my I don't know. I guess it's because I'm playing in a window. I mean, it's a 1280 by 720 window, so it's the same aspect ratio it would be if I was playing full screen. I'm not sure. Desktop Dungeons. Yeah, Desktop Dungeons, that's a... it's an interesting game. I really liked it at first, but then the strategy went a little over my head once you reach a certain point in the game, and I got intimidated with it, and I kind of gave up. Or intimidated by it, I should say. Hello, little kitty cat. And just draw, what's up? Yeah, exactly. I mean, that's the thing about Jeff. He's, he's always... I mean, he's not like... he's not always quick in varying his strategy and trying new things, but he always does eventually figure things out, and he's just fun to watch. He has a really cool personality. I always like listening to any podcast he was on and stuff. Oh, still no keys, damn it. I don't know what this thing does. I guess it... Oh. Hey, Pride. I guess it just has a chance to revive you if you die or something. Maybe it... Well, I mean, the Ankh revives you as the blue baby if you die. So I guess the broken Ankh just has a chance of doing that, probably. Which, I forget what... I don't know if I still need to do anything with the blue baby or not. Strength A. Running a little low on health. Oh, well, there's some. I guess I might as well use my bombs here. I could bomb my way into the item room. Oh, never mind. No need to. Yeah, exactly, little kitty cat. He's very ambitious. Like, he started playing the first Dark Souls as a joke. Because he was streaming Black Mesa, the remake of Half-Life that came out not too long ago. About a year ago, a year and a half ago. And he started playing Dark Souls as a joke because, you know, the whole thing was, hey, look at this old dude fail miserably at this incredibly hard game. And, he liked the game so much that he just kept going with it, and... yeah, let's use the bomb here. Broken Ankh is just a chance to respawn as Blue Baby. Yeah, that's what I thought. Actually, I'm curious now. Let me, take advantage of... Oh, wow. I actually beat both the chest and the dark place as Blue Baby. How the hell did I do that? I have no idea, but if I do revive as Blue Baby, then essentially the run's over because I don't need to do anything as the Blue Baby. So, I mean, if I do die and come back as the Blue Baby, it's not the end of the world. I'll try to finish the run. I just won't be making any real progress. Oh, that's a cool room. Half-Life 3 confirmed. Actually, Half-Life 3 is Frog Fractions 2. But you guys didn't know that. That's what that whole thing was about. Oh my god. Is that the Pyromania thing? Oh, I love that. Two runs in a row. One of my new favorite items in the game. Now all I need is something that combos with it, and I'll be set. Let's see, do I want to open the item shop? I only have 8 coins. Well, there are plenty of hearts in that secret room, so let's go on ahead and see what's in here. Great. Let's open a chest. Oh, let's open it would be a key and some other stuff, but things don't always work out the way you plan. Well, I didn't get the haunt in either of the first two levels, which is a good sign, because the haunt is my least favorite boss to get in the basement / the cellar. It used to be Widow, but Widow's not as hard to deal with as the haunt. I mean, right now I'm, man, my tears really suck. That tears down pill really kind of boned me. I mean, it's just taking me forever to kill these egg sacks. Widow herself is going down relatively quickly, though. Or himself. Itself. God, look at how long it takes me to kill these things. It's just absurd. Tears and shot speed up. Well, that's definitely helpful. If I can get damage or tears from this devil room, I might do it. Holy Mantle. Oh yeah, that's probably the best new item this game added. The ability, I mean, basically every room you go into gives you one free hit. That item is probably the only reason I was able to get the no damage achievements in Rebirth. If it weren't for that, I doubt I would have. I definitely wouldn't have gotten Mama's Boy. Well, let's see. I can get myself another 9 lives, and I would be left with only one heart. If I had a bunch of soul hearts, I might actually do this, but I'm not going to take the risk. I've been taking a lot more chances like that in Rebirth than I did in the original, though. And sometimes it works out for me. Like, if I got that and I got two more Guppy items, then it would be worth the trade-off, but I'm not in a good enough position as far as my other stats go to sacrifice that much health, so I'm just going to get out of here. Yeah, I haven't unlocked the Lost yet, little kitty cat, and I'm not sure if I'm going to. I mean, I'll probably at least unlock the Lost, just because the process of doing so is so insane and convoluted. It'll be fun tearing my hair out and trying that, but I think it'll actually be possible. But I'm never going to beat this game on hard with the Lost, so the getting all the achievements is out of the question in this one. Holy Mantle, Infamy, Goathead. Yeah, Leo's a cool item. Or Thunder Thighs, the other item that lets you just walk over rocks to break them. Also really cool. Alright, give me something good. Oh, well. More bombs, always good, I guess. If I need to heal myself. Oh god. Nope, no keys. Couldn't do that if I wanted to. Which I'm not sure if I do. Oh, hey. These guys probably still hurt if you touch them. I don't know, though. There's some enemies where the act of physically touching them doesn't actually hurt, but being hit by their projectile or being caught in their explosion is the thing that hurts. Wait. Did I not get that secret room down there? I should have. So yeah, I don't know what the deal with the bomb fly is. I should probably test that. Oh, I guess I didn't. Weird. I'll take it. Find black markets a lot. Oh, is that that's what those secret underground shops are, I guess. Black market. I guess that makes sense. I don't like the black market that much because I don't want to give up a heart for a non-devil room item. Like, it's just the normal stuff that you would find in item shops, but you have to give up a heart for it. And I don't even like giving up a heart for devil room items. I don't do that very often, so I don't really make use of the black market usually. Like, if I find one of those underground passage things, I'm usually hoping it's just a free item. Of course, the black market does let you skip a lot of the, or it lets you skip to the next level, which if I'm on the womb or something, I'll definitely take advantage of that. But usually, if I'm not on the womb yet, then I'll want to I want to actually kill the boss just to get the item from it. Shit. Well, it's not the best item you can get after boss, but it's like a devil deal shop, yeah. Which is cool. I just usually don't take advantage of it. No, I mean if I have 12 hearts or something, then you know that's a different matter. But I usually don't. Well, I could get the map. Meh. I'd rather save my coins. So I want to start streaming something else. I want to keep playing this, of course, and I will. But I kind of want to stream a game blind. Like, I mean, streaming this is kind of like streaming a game blind because I still don't know what a lot of stuff is and how a lot of stuff works. But I want to play through a game that I've never experienced before. I haven't done that in a while. On stream, I mean. Watching Jeff's Dark Souls stream makes me want to do that because it's just interesting watching someone discover a game, you know? Like, I really like watching people figure stuff out. I don't know if everyone likes that, but something I'd be into trying. Like, I tried doing that with FTL, and I thought that was pretty interesting. I should probably play some more FTL, come to think of it. I haven't played that in a while. I just wish I had more time to stream. I'd stream a lot more stuff if I didn't have to work all the time. And if working all the time didn't make me not feel like streaming. Yeah, there's a bunch more stuff I want to do. Mix it up a little bit. Not just stuck in a Binding of Isaac rut. Quit vomiting out spiders. It's really gross. Evil up. I still don't know what evil does. I think it's just like a chance to spawn Doom Hearts or something. But I don't remember. I think I looked it up at one point. Boy, I'm glad they made a walking version of these enemies. You know, this is my favorite enemy in the game by far. And, you know, making a version that can walk around, obviously, is only an improvement. A+ design decision. Man, the worst rooms in this game are the rooms with the heads that continually spew blood, like even after the room's clear, and these guys having to, you know, dodge the projectiles, but still get these guys into a position where you can hit them is just a nightmare. We call that the run ender. Dark hearts, yeah, that's what I thought. I called them Doom Hearts because I don't know. That's the it's a coin I turned for them. Yeah, there you go. tiers are still pretty underwhelming. But I'm doing okay. Ah, shit, that sucks, just drop. I'd try lowering my bitrate if I thought it would help, but I'm pretty sure it's just a sight issue that there's nothing I can do about it. Ooh. Well, that's helpful. I was just lamenting the sorry state of my tears, and it gave me just what I needed. I am recording this, right? Yeah, okay, good. So yeah, if the lag is getting too obnoxious, you know, you can always just peace out and it'll be on YouTube later, so. Nice. Thanks, BBF. So you know, you'll be able to watch it then, normally. Let's see. I still have plenty of bombs, so... Well, not plenty, but I have enough. No! Don't get the tick. God, the tick sucks. It's actually a pretty close one. I came really close to picking it up by mistake. I mean, not that the Ankh is a super great item or anything, but, you know, I might find a much better trinket later on, and... Tips to survive with one heart container as Eve. Well, this doesn't work for everyone, but my advice would be try not to get hit. Sorry, that's a bad joke. Also with Holy Mantle. Well, Holy Mantle is definitely a... Definitely a great item to have in that situation. Oh crap, I can't see the map, so my Spelunker hat is useless. So, the trick to unlocking the Lost, which is the one character I haven't unlocked yet, is you have to die to enemies in a very specific way. Like, I remember the first step is you have to die to a Mullaboom, which is, it's the version of those things I just killed that have a bomb in them. You have to die to one of those with Isaac. And then there are like six more steps that are similar. And if you die to anything else, it messes it up and you have to start all over again. With dying to a Mullaboom with Isaac. And then the last one, I think, is dying, getting stomped by Satan as someone. I forget who. And then if you do all of this bullshit in the right order, you unlock the horrible character that if you get hit at all, you lose. Well, I'm not going to look up a seed just to do something like that, little kitty cat. That's not how I roll. We're going to do it the honest man's way. It's pretty good advice, Sterile Prophet. Also, adding to what he said, which is get some spirit hearts and then get into poor Babylon state. Adding to that, if you can find... the Soul Converter, which is the, God, I forget what the item actually is. It's not Guppy's Tail, because that's a cursed thing. It's not the head, because that's the Fly Generator. It's not the body, because that's a 9 lives thing. Guppy's Paw, that's it. If you can find Guppy's Paw and turn your one heart into 3 soul hearts, then you will be constantly in the Horror Babylon state, and you'll have 3 times as much health. So I would definitely do that if you do happen to find Guppy's Paw, which I know is not very likely, but Unfortunately, that's the best advice I have. Have I opened the item shop yet? Oh, wait. It was just greed, wasn't it? Or was that last level? I don't remember. Anyway. I hate not having a map. I feel so lost. Oh, it's almost like that's the point or something. Feeling lost. Wait. Well, I guess getting stomped only counts as an explosion if it's mom or Satan, because when he stomped me, it still did damage to me. Lemon party, range up, lockdown, paralysis, great. Hey Expo. Yeah, a lot of people having issues with Twitch tonight. I'm sorry, guys. I wish I could do something. I could switch to Hitbox, but then I'd still have to interrupt the stream halfway through, and who knows if Hitbox would work. I mean, Hitbox usually works okay, but you never know. No, Oxbow, I haven't even unlocked the Lost yet. I doubt I'll ever be able to beat the game as a Lost. Yeah, that's true, Proba Steve. I do have decent shot speed. And damage. Oh god. It's like I forgot who I was fighting. Let's stand right in front of Gluttony. I love that sound effect because it really reminds me of the Baron of Hell from Doom. And the sound effect scared the shit out of me when I was a kid. I mean, not that it's a scary sound, but just that I knew I was going to have to fight a Baron of Hell. And that always scared the shit out of me. I mean, I've said I'll never be able to do XYZ in The Binding of Isaac before, and other games, and I proved myself wrong. So, you never know. Like, I never thought I would get all the Splunky achievements, and I ended up pulling that off. Man, it's giving me a lot of bomb power-ups. I've got hot bombs, I've got bigger bombs, I've got the bomb fly, I've got bomb myself to heal myself. I wonder if the fire the burning bomb leaves behind heals me as well. I don't know, I can't tell because I'm at full health. Probably not, but that would be really cool if it did. Hey, you suck. Oh yeah, that is true. You do get free devil deals with the Lost. But I still don't think it'll be enough. Because one hit, I mean, if you could get soul hearts, you know, that would, yeah, that doesn't heal you. Oh well. If you could get soul hearts, that would be one thing, but you can't even do that. Yeah, that's what I figured, Stero Prophet. Oh well. I guess I don't want to get too greedy. Damn it. And it's going to be another double boss room, too. I hate those. Either that or, Fred. Who's always in the double-wide boss rooms for some reason. Yeah, definitely, Oxbow. That's something... Oh, crap. I missed a soul heart. I'll have to go back for that. That's something I've definitely noticed, is, there are a lot of situations where I'm willing to give up my hearts for soul hearts. Because you're just a lot more survivable in those situations in this game than in the original. Like, I never use Guppy's Paw in the original Binding of Isaac, but I use it all the time in this version. Just because I know that, you know, with all those soul hearts, I will, I'm likely to find something that'll work with it. Either getting more Guppy items, and, I mean, that's something I've done a lot more in this version as well, is turn into Guppy. In the original, I only turn into Guppy a handful of times. Well, it's only been a handful of times here too, but it's been a bigger handful. Can't hear audio. Is that just Private Steve? Can anyone else not hear audio? Let me check my settings. Still looks good on my end. Is anyone else having that issue? Yep, Dark Bomb does drop spiders sometimes, Oxbow, which makes him not as useful. But still pretty useful. Oh, it's fixed now. Okay, that's good. Ooh, blue map. And it's only 7 coins. Well, I guess I don't need it since I already have the Splunker hat. But sometimes if you know where the secret rooms are, it can be a little easier to suss out which way you need to go to fight the boss. Sometimes. Not always. I don't know what this thing does. It says challenge up or something like that. And I don't know what that means. I could buy another lemon party pill, but I'm good. I will buy another key though. Oh yeah, that's true. I've never gotten the Soul Converter and Guppy's Paw in the same run. But yeah, that would be pretty amazing. Of course, you know, like Oxbow was saying, sometimes you want to be in a situation where you have 12 soul hearts because you might find the Horde of Babylon or pretty sure there are more items. Wait, oh. Here's the maze. Pretty sure there are more items where having no actual health is an advantage. And also you can do all of the challenge rooms, which is a nice bonus. I'll take Lemon Party with me. Screw it. None of these cards or pills is worth coming back for. More champions, but damage up. Oh, the champions are like the buffed versions of the enemies, right? Yeah, sure. Little Kitty Cat says it's worth taking, and I trust their judgment. Every cat I've ever known has been on the up and up. That sucks. Sorry, Private Steve. Like I was saying, it'll be on YouTube, so if you can even hear me. If not, then apologies if you're watching this later on the tubes. Necronomicon, eh? Well, I don't have an activated item. Do I have anything that combos with it? I don't think so. I don't know what would combo with it. Something that lets you charge faster. I don't know. I'll think about a Satan. Oh yeah, champions do drop items more often. That's a good point. That's a good reason to take it as well. Oh. Dang it. Oh yeah, the Lord of the Flies thing. Oh wait, no, you're talking about turning into Guppy, yeah. Well, I haven't gotten any Guppy items yet, so still 3 more items for me. Or does that thing I picked up count as a does that count as a Guppy item? That'd be kind of weird. All right, where the hell am I going? Okay. Yeah. What's this? Telepills? Yeah. Boy, sure would be nice to not get randomly teleported. Where the... God, it's teleporting me all over the place. This sucks. I thought the maze, it could only... Stop it! Jesus Christ! I thought it could only teleport you, like, one room away. But it's going kind of nuts. Can I please go this way? Thank you. Oh, right, yeah, that's, like, Guppy's Paw is just a great item in this version. Much better than the original, I think. Or at least, I've had more opportunities to use it. Seems like Lemon Party shouldn't do anything to Peep. You know, just speaking logically. But, I'm not gonna complain. I wonder why the first one died so much more quickly. It didn't seem like I did that much more damage to it. See? Well, hell, now that I had that extra health, I might have gone for the Necronomicon. But the Devil Room is gone, so oh well. Oh, I thought I got them both in the Lemon Party. I didn't realize it was just the left one. Yeah, I haven't gotten Lord of the Flies yet, actually. Which you think it wouldn't be that hard, because there are plenty of fly items. But I guess I just haven't been lucky enough to get 3 in one run. Hi, Mom. Oh, Jesus Christ, 4 of them? I wasn't expecting that many. I guess I should. Really, Peep is your most hated boss? I don't like Peep, but they're not the worst. Now, oh, God damn it! Now the Bloat, which is like the alternate version of Peep, that I can get on board with. That is a horrible boss. As seen in the movie Horrible Bosses 2, starring Jason. I almost said Jason Statham. God, I'm blanking on his name. The guy from Arrested Development. I saw the first Horrible Bosses. It was okay. I did not see the sequel, though. I know it's Jason something. You stand above the Bloat, he's simple. Yeah, if he's not... You know, jumping, teleporting above you all the time. Man, I don't have many keys. Oh yeah, I got Pyromaniac Oxbow. It's awesome. It was one of the first items I got on this run. Herbal Bosses 2 is better than the first one. Really? Do you think it would be the opposite? That's usually how those movies go. Am I not? Oh, it looked like I wasn't dealing damage to that guy. Ooh, Eternal Heart. I'll leave that right there for now. I'll come back for it. Don't let me forget. Bateman, thank you, Sterile Prophet. That sounds kind of like Jason Statham. I know I forgot to go in the secret room in the previous room. I'll do that right after this. Nice. Dropping a lot of soul hearts all of a sudden. Oh, I might check it out now, Sterile. Because I didn't hate the first one. I mean, it wasn't great or anything, but for a comedy, it was okay. Lucky Toe. Meh. Why not? A rare champion. Yeah, I don't know if I've seen those before. There haven't been a ton of great comedies recently. At least not that I've seen. I have enough keys to do this now. Oh, that was well worth it. I was hoping it would be another dice room so I could refuse to use it. Because every time I use a dice room, I end up screwing myself somehow. Hello, Sloth. I feel a good run. Oh, thank you, Oxbow. I feel like this one's going okay so far. Oh, Cricket's head doesn't count for Guppy. Yeah, that makes sense. Apparently there's a Cricket's body in this game. I guess it's something you have to unlock because I sure haven't seen it yet. What do I have, the Emperor? I use strength and then use the Emperor in the womb. Well, no, I won't be able to, shit. I won't be able to come back for it because I'm fighting Mom. Damn it! It didn't look like... I think that thing should have been touching me. Blue one is Lemon Party, I think. I forget what the other one is. Eh, not worth it. I wish I could just hit start and go to a submenu and it shows me what pills I've discovered in this round and what they do. That'd be helpful. But no, that would be providing you with information. Can't do that. Is that a... Man, something about the color palette and the depths. Sometimes I think something looks like an X-Rock. But it's, I mean, that one looks lighter than those two, right? But, I mean, it sort of has a tiny little X on it. It wasn't anything weird. Telepills. Ech. Yeah, I have gotten a few, or a couple range ups. I didn't know Cricket's head reduced, or oh, is that Cricket's body? Yeah. I like having the fish head. I don't know if it's better than the lucky toe or not. Ooh, I could get the heart jar. It's actually worth taking since I don't have any activated items. And let's donate some coin. Since I'm probably not going to need them after this level. Bomb all rocks. Well, I mean, I want to save my bombs. If I had 99 bombs, I'd go around bombing all the rocks, but, dry baby rocks? Is there a dry baby I could have taken that I missed? Ooh! This is a pretty cool item. See, I like it in this version because you can see the shadow of the daddy long legs leg following you around. It's really neat. I'm not sure if that was in the first one or not, and I just never noticed it, or if they added it. That's a really nice touch. It really feels like someone's up there watching over you. Don't bomb rock skulls. I love finding dry baby and ghost baby in random skulls. Oh yeah, I have found those in random skulls before. Black hearts and cards from the skulls. Yeah, skulls are worth bombing sometimes. Also, the blue fire is worth bombing because they drop soul hearts a lot. See, that's a boss challenge room up there. I can't get in there. Okay, yeah, I'm done. Unless I want to go into the pain room. Which, there is a heart down there, I guess I might as well. Oh, that other pill was a lockdown. I'm glad I didn't buy it now. I don't know, I've always been very stingy with my bombs, especially... I mean, I'm not going to be fighting Satan on this run, but if I was, then... I would be even more stingy. But even in general, like, 18 bombs seems like a lot, but, I need more. I mean, I don't want to use my bombs because there's always a chance I'll be able to use them to heal later on, you know? And I need every little bit of healing and power that I can get. Oh yeah, that's right. I can just let her slump on me. Almost forgot. I don't know why that counts as a bomb. But I'm glad it does. Oh crap, I won't be able to go back for that Eternal Heart. Oh well, I would have lost it anyway. Because I got hit. Ooh. Alright. Still need to do the chest on this run, so I'll go ahead and go for the Polaroid. Yeah, but that's so unlikely to find those oxbow. Just doesn't seem worth it to me. Like, I don't even really like bombing walls to see if there's a secret room there, because... I don't know. Like, even if I don't have Pyromania, I'd rather hold on to my bombs just to be able to... Just to be able to take bosses down faster, you know? Okay, this is completely unsubstantiated, but I have this weird superstition that the gray question mark secret room is always close to the boss, so I'm going to go in that direction. We'll see if my superstition has any sort of basis in reality, which I'm sure it doesn't. That's why they call it a superstition. But just to humor myself. Yeah, exactly, Oxbow. Like, the black market is super rare. I've only found the underground item room a few times, a handful of times as well. Of course, I don't bomb rocks that often, but I mean, there's so many rocks on every level. It could be under any one of them, you know? Oh, retro treasure room. Is that what those are called? Retro because it's like the thing in Zelda? Oh, I have plenty of hearts. I'm spoiled for hearts. Oh yeah, the Lucky Rock token. That's awesome. If I had that, I would be bombing rocks really often. Especially if I had like the earthquake machine or something. It's a really good combo. And it doesn't really... The Daddy Longlegs attack doesn't really have any oomph to it. There's no sound effect associated with it or anything. Just kinda lazy, like, hey, what's up? Oh, did I step on you? Sorry. Man, I hate this pill. Makes you fire tears diagonally. I'm not sure if it's like time based or if you have to fire a certain number of shots before the effect goes away or what, but it's annoying. The womb rocks drop placenta rarely. Yeah, but they also drop projectiles pretty often, so I don't usually mess with womb rocks that much. I have a pretty high chance of exploding in a bloody mess. You suck. I'll stick with the fish head. Very well. Just to make absolutely sure. I probably don't want to do this, but... three chests. I don't know. That's pretty good. Might be worth it, especially with two red chests. Could be something good in here. Well, hey, I got a soul heart out of it. Man, I'm kind of tearing stuff up. I mean, not cockiness, humility. Not jinxing myself. What's the plural of monstro? Is it just monstros? I guess most words that end in O, you just either add an S or add ES. I was going to say monstri, but that's if it ended in US, I think. Yeah, you have to be careful with Leo and Thunder Thighs in the womb, Oxbow. Jesus Christ! I hope there are enough hands in that level. In that room. That level. How much you want to bet this is the wrong way? I don't care. I'm having fun. Yeah, it probably is just Monstro's Oxbow. I was just wondering if there would be some weird grammar thing. Some weird grammar thing. Until I aced my English classes. Oh, there's a heart there, but I can't get to it. That's a bummer. Let's go ahead and heal up, I guess. You can shoot the idle shooter heads, and your shots can blow up and heal you. Really? Have I been in a room with those? I don't think so. I'd really like to see how that works. Man, there's just hearts everywhere here. Yeah, it's probably not Monstri. And I totally went the wrong way. Oh well. At least I can get this. I'm sure this will be worth it. Meh. With Fire Mind. Is that an item? What the heck is this? Wait, I couldn't read that. Imaginary friend. Is that good? I've never gotten that before. I guess I unlocked it recently. Ooh, man. Callus, that's a good find. Oh man. That's a good find too, Mom's Toenail. Since I have the since I have the Pyromania. Oh man, that's another good find. Damn. Three good trinkets and one potentially good trinket. Oh, right. Flaming Tears. Okay, gotcha. Yeah, I can see how that would combo well. Alright, so does anyone know whether this is better than the Kalos or Cancer? Because if it is, I'll take it. But if not, I gotta go with one of these. Man, I don't know which one of these I would take, though. The Callus is so good. So is Cancer. This might be good. I mean, Mom's Toenail would be cool to have, but realistically, I'm probably not going to get stomped by her that often enough to make it worth passing up either of these. Spawns a familiar that my other familiars will follow around on a random course. But I don't have any familiars. I mean, I have the fly, but I don't think that counts. Little Kitty Cat says Cancer, Oxbow says Callus. Man. I gotta go with the protection, because there are just so many situations where having the Callus is amazing. I do hate passing up Cancer, but my damage is pretty good right now, so I can probably deal with it. Sero Prophet says Cancer. Eh. Better DPM. Yeah, but like, if I have to fight Mama Gertie or someone where I have to worry about stepping on spikes all the time, then I'd really hate not having the Callus. But man, Cancer is so good. Be able to kill stuff so fast. Oh well. Either way, I should blow this up while I'm here. Yeah, I mean, I gotta go with the DPM, because ultimately, being able to kill stuff faster, you know, the best defense is a good offense, etc., etc. Yeah, Mon's Purse would be pretty nice right now. Come on! Like, I don't know if there's somewhere special. I have some. Does he only pop up when I'm standing still? Bombs or key? Well, I'm not sure if I need 19 keys, but, thanks, I guess. Oh, you know what? I should just use this. I bet that'll take me right next to the boss room. We're not. Okay. Well, this is oh, what's it called? Freaking puddle time. Number one, the pee thing. Puddle. I don't know. I'm not using a bone to get any of these. Because I only have six now. My amazing supply of bombs dwindled to nothing because of a dumb pill. I want to go this way. Don't know why I did that. That was dumb. What's my damage at? Five. Lemon Party, yes, thank you, Oxbow. I guess I blocked it out of my mind because I don't want to think about lemon parties. I repressed that memory. Dang, stuff dies fast. It's not that I kill stuff fast. I have nothing to do with this process. Stuff just dies fast. What? What? Come on! Oh wait, Lemon Party is a blue pill, never mind. I don't know what the yellow one was. Probably something bad. Well, the boss is not in this corner either, it looks like. I went all of the worst possible ways. The Ace of Spades. The Ace of Spades, etc. Yeah, I love Daddy Long Legs. It's a heck of an item. I bet I was on the right track in the top right-hand corner. I just did not continue going that way for some reason. How did I take half a heart of damage? Shouldn't everything be doing a full heart to me in the womb? Well, let's see. Sure. Cancer was the right call? Yeah, I think so. As much as I do love the callus, I can just walk right over that blood. Oh. Well, you're not the boss. I mean, you're a boss. You're a mini boss. Where the. And the boss is, must be in a really weird place. I didn't think the map would continue that far in this direction. Shows what I know, I guess. Yep, there it is. Wow. Oh shit. I thought they all died. Counting my chickens before they hatch. All right, I'm gonna. Well, I guess I can fight this boss first, and I'm gonna go around to fill up my jar. Oh wait, this is an XL level. I didn't even realize. No wonder this layout is so fucked. Well, I guess that's cool. Get mom's heart out of the way. Or it lives, rather. I wasn't sure if that would deal damage to it lives or not. Doesn't look like it. Oh god. Thanks, DLL. You made that. Shit. You made that fight much more pleasant. Alright, let's go fill up my jar. Thank you. If GGA stands for good job, as I believe it does. If it stands for something else, then no thanks to you. I can't get that heart. Kind of a long walk, but I'm not in a big hurry to get out of here. It's Friday night, and I feel alright. I have all the time in the world. It's not a pill I want to get, is it? I think it's tears down or something. Yeah. Wish there was a way I could blow up my own bomb fly. That'd be nice. Give myself a free heal in every room. I mean, I can still do that. I just have to get really close to the enemy and probably hit myself in the process, which would defeat the purpose. Alright, let me get a drink and my beverage here. Okay, well, I have a secret room right here, so might as well go that direction to start with. Yeah, exactly, Oxbow. It's a bad habit I still need to break of myself is pressing a direction as I enter a room. Oh, hey. And get my 23 bombs back. I think I'll do that. And cartridge is cool, but not as cool as answer, obviously. Alright, might as well keep going this way. Get that other secret room. You'll notice that my superstition was proved to be not based in fact. Which is a surprising development, since most superstitions, you know, obviously, are 100% scientifically verifiable. Aww, look at the little haunt. It's cute. Bloody penny? Eh. Man, I wish I had, if I got unbreakable, I could just stand around and just let my bomb fly and Daddy Longlegs do all the work for me. That'd be such a nice item to get right now. See, that's the one way I could conceive of winning the game as a lost, is if I get unbreakable and enough stuff to deal damage that I don't have to move. That's probably the most broken item in the game now, actually, is unbreakable. Now that I, of course, now that I think of it. So yeah, maybe I can get all the achievements. I just have to either cheat and look up a seed where I'll get unbreakable and enough items. Now you give me that. Oy. And enough items that combo with it. Or just, you know, keep trying randomly until I get a seed that does that. Wait. That's not... Is that more trinket room? No. I don't know what the fanny pack does. It says filled with goodies. Oh, hey, Emperor. That's cool. I mean, it kind of sucks that I'm so low on health, but, hopefully, Oh, right, placenta. Yep, I beat Mega Satan with Mom's knife, little kitty cat. Sit still and let them walk into you. Well, the problem with that is your knife would still only be facing in one direction, so you'd have to be pretty patient. But yeah, that would be a good combo. Alright, do I want to use... Okay. Well, I'm full on health. I guess I might as well just go straight to the boss, unless I want to save the Emperor card for the chest, so I can go straight to that boss, which I probably do since the boss is right here. Glad I didn't waste the Emperor card on that. Alright, got both of the secret rooms. It's a mini boss room down there, which... Nah. Alright, well, I'm not super well equipped for this fight, but I'll give it my all. Oh god. Thank you, Placenta. Oh god. Wait. Oh, that sound effect. I guess it's making that sound effect for a different reason. I thought that was the health up sound effect. Shit. When I say I'm not super well equipped for this fight, all I mean is I don't have a lot of projectile defense. I don't have any orbitals. I don't have any kind of shield or anything. Nothing to deal with Bullet Hell in particular. I mean, I'm pretty well equipped considering how much damage I'm dealing and stuff, but yeah, could always be better. Any orbitals plus Mom's knife and unbreakable, yep. The only issue you'll run into is rooms where enemies are like trapped behind pits and stuff and they can't get to you. See, that's why you want, I think the best items to have with Unbreakable are Steady Long Legs and the toenail. Just stompy stompy action. Yeah. Oh, right, yeah. Unbreakable is the item description, not the name. But yeah, it's a Nautilus, the thing that gives you the Tanuki suit ability. Spider Revenge, okay. Well, if I had Mom's Knife, I'd go with the Unicorn Stomp, but, well, since I'm teleporting straight to the boss, I guess there's no reason not to take the Unicorn Horn. Alright, well, here is nothing, guys. I mean, not that the Unicorn Horn is going to help me in this fight, but, it'll help me more than the jar, I guess. And go invincible for a short period of time. Thanks, Chad. Shit. There's the sound effect again. Stop getting my hopes up. I'm like, hey, I'm regenerating really fast. Shit! What the? Oh god. Achievement unlocked! Store credit. I worried myself there for a minute because I took like 3 hits in a row that I shouldn't have. Remember to use bombs. Eh. I don't need bombs. I should have been doing that a lot though to heal myself up. Oh well. It all worked out in the end. Thank you, thank you. It was a good run. I feel better about my streaming now. My last stream was pretty rough. As far as being successful goes. Alright, well. Let's keep this party going. I could do another Lazarus run and try to do the Dark Room. Is there anyone I haven't done the chest as? Just Magdalene. I could keep trying to get the Dark Room with Kane, although I was having terrible luck with Kane the last run. Who would be fun? I mean, I could do an Eden run. I have a few tokens. But, I've done everything there is to do with Eden. I could try some hard runs. Just to make things interesting. Or I could always try a challenge too, but I should probably start the stream with a challenge instead of starting this late into the stream. I want to do an Eden run. I haven't really tried the game on hard that much. Alright, so I start with the Unicorn Horn and really terrible tears. Okay, well, that's what the, what the fates had in store for me. That's what I'll deal with. Try some boss rush. Yeah, I could try to get to the boss rush. My only issue is I'm a big windbag, and I would probably not be able to get to the boss rush during a stream because I spend so much time talking. I mean, I guess I could be Azazel and just, you know, kind of rush my way there. Ironically, rush to the boss rush. What is this, Russia? Pull up my menu again. What, this? Or do you want to see the main menu? Because if you want to see the main menu, then let me know. I can back out. But this is my, This is the seed if you want to play along at home. Oh, is that what you want, Oxbow? The seed? Yeah. There you go. Very fun third run. Yeah? Well, it's my second run. But, we can pretend it's the third for the sake of the seed. Very fun third run. Not looking for a crappy... Z. Okay. Cole. Yeah. I don't like Cole. I don't understand what it's supposed to do. Like, I don't understand why it's good. The only thing Cole does is make it hard to see where I'm shooting in the dark. That's it. I mean, I remember in the original, it says some BS about, like, does more damage the farther it travels or something, but that didn't seem to be happening. Oh no, don't apologize, Oxbow. I was just being weird. So I follow a guy named Yama Yama Ding Dong, who was a big Splunky streamer, but I'll take it. But ever since Rebirth came out, he's been playing that a lot. And he just plays an insane amount of video games on stream. It's kind of Oh, hey, a secret. I can't get to it. What? Why are those rocks blowing up? That was weird. But anyway, he's been doing Eden hard runs for the past like 5 days or something. And he's on a streak of like 75 wins in a row or something insane like that. It is just incomprehensible to me how someone can be that good at this game. And he streams like 8 hours a day or something, just mind-boggling. Like, I don't know. I mean, he's a partner, so he gets like, people can subscribe to him and stuff, but I don't think he has enough followers to make a living or anything. I don't know what he does all day. But I haven't actually watched any Binding of Isaac streams because, you know, I want to keep myself relatively spoiler-free for a while. I got a kick out of watching him play Splunky, though. The more distance tiers travel, the more damage they'll do. Yeah, that's what I thought, but that never seems to actually be the case. I don't know what the... I don't know. I mean, I guess it's doing like an imperceptibly higher amount of damage. No clue. I just don't like being able to see my bullets some of the time. I mean, not that you should have to see your bullets, but I don't know. It's annoying. But yeah, go check him out. Yama Yama Ding Dong. That's Y-A-M-A. Y-A-M-A Ding Dong. He's probably streaming right now. Seems like every time I look at my subscribed list, he's always playing. I mean, I don't know how interesting it would be to watch him play Binding of Isaac, because I only ever watched him play Spelunky, but he's a pretty chill guy. Like, he just has superhuman patience. Like, I cannot believe how patient he is, because watching him do ghost runs or ghost mining in Splunky is just the most mind-boggling thing. Like, he can have a stream going for just like, or he can spend hours on one run. Like, he can be 4 hours into a run and then die and just be like, oh well, and he'll just start again. That's how he rolls. I have plenty of soul hearts. It's probably safe for me to pick that up. I don't know how many soul hearts I have, but I'm sure it's enough. Oh, I mean, I'm not too worried about spoilers. I mean, it is fun to discover stuff in this game. And actually, I've probably discovered everything. I was really worried about being spoiled. So yeah, don't worry about it. Like, when I say relatively spoiler-free, that just means I don't want to sit and watch someone play the game for hours until I've discovered a fair bit of it, you know? Ooh, broken watch. That might be worth bombing some coins. Well, I only have 2 bombs, so meh. If I get more coins, I'll definitely come back for the broken watch. Where am I going? Oh yeah, that was the mini boss. Yeah, like the only thing I'm really worried about is this game at this point doesn't have anything I'm really worried about being spoiled on. Like, if I was playing a puzzle game or something, I wouldn't want like the solutions to the puzzles, because that's kind of lame. Or I wouldn't want, like, blatant information as to where secrets are and stuff like that. But at this point, it's probably fine with Binding of Isaac. Shit. I mean, my whole thing about streaming video games is I like doing it. I have a lot of fun doing it, but I don't want to take away any of the fun of playing the game, you know? Of the discovery and, you know, the figuring shit out and all that. Alright, so I'll save my crystal ball from the next level so I can reveal the map and immediately get a soul heart. You're 99? Nice. Or 999? Nice. I'll get there eventually. I'm kind of surprised I'm not there by now. Yeah, me too, Oxbow. Like, I was over 500 quite a while ago. Oh, it's a card, not a soul heart. Like, I was over 500, and then I bombed, like, 80 coins out of it, so I kind of had to build my way back up. You jerk. So I actually don't know what the difference between normal and hard is. Because so far, this doesn't seem that much different than a normal run. Like, I guess it's not dropping as much health or something? I mean, the enemies... Oops. Oh, okay. The enemies don't seem particularly tougher. Like, I guess there are a few more champion enemies than there would otherwise be. Yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to seeing what happens when I max out the donation machine. I mean, I'm not saying that to be like, look how awesome I am. I'm playing on hard and it's like a normal run. Like, I honestly don't know what the difference is. Maybe the bosses are harder? Hard mode has more champions which drop less and other stuff. Okay. Keys drop less, but they fix that. I mean, that's the thing. You could have a run on normal where keys hardly ever drop and you just get screwed. Flush. I actually really like that item. It makes every enemy on the screen turn into poop. But man, I don't know if I can give up the crystal ball. It's like the Book of Revelations, but better. Well, I guess it's kind of a wash, since it doesn't always drop soul hearts. But still, it's as good as the Book of Revelations, if not arguably better. Hard mode reduces red heart drops. Yeah, I guess you're right. I haven't seen very many of those. So far, anyway. Hold on a sec. I have to take off my sweatshirt. It got a little warm in here. Settle down. I'm still wearing a t-shirt underneath. Sorry about that. See, how long have I been going? An hour and a half? Okay. Probably going to call it after this run, unless this run ends super quickly or something. Be cool if I could get my first hard mode win during a stream. Like I said, I haven't really messed with hard mode that much. I think I played hard mode exactly once, and I died. But I mean, it wasn't like a, oh man, this is so much harder, and that's why I died. It just felt like a bad run. But I guess the odds could just be stacked slightly less in my favor, and that can make a huge difference overall. It's kind of like how in D&D, well, 4th edition anyway, I'm not sure about these new editions, but it's kind of like how in D&D, oops, a plus one bonus can just make a gigantic difference in the course of the game. Like, you wouldn't think plus one would really be that big of a deal, but, you know, what the hell? I mean, this is only the basement. I might as well go to all these other rooms, even though I don't technically have to, because there might be something good in them. I mean, it's not like the womb, where I want to avoid as many rooms as possible at all costs. But yeah, like those little differences can add up to big differences. Okay. Oh, grab that. Why not? You only need to go to Mom's heart where it lives. Oh, you mean do the levels after that? Oh, you mean... I'm not sure what you mean. So, does Sheol and the Cathedral, do those just not exist in hard mode? Not sure how that works. Man, I'm gonna have to use 2 bombs to get that extra rock, but it'll probably be worth it. I want to use that now, just to start building it back up. Ooh! Nice. Gotta say, I'm feeling okay about this run. It would definitely be nice if I had more offensive capabilities. Yeah, that was a champion. Boy, well, it didn't drop anything. Interesting. I mean, it's not like the champion enemies are, like, insanely hard or anything. I mean, they take a little longer to kill, and they're occasionally a little more dangerous, but, I don't know. Hey, broken watch again. Still don't have enough. Well, I almost have enough. Screw it. Give me that coin. Yeah, I think it's broken, but that's okay. Because even a broken watch is right twice a day. And that kind of turned into a little poem there. Hey! That was awful nice of you, Spider. You can do every boss on hard mode for sure, and you get red marks on your character sheet over the bosses you take down in hard. Oh, for the trophy not lost. I see. Okay. So there's an achievement for beating Mom's heart where it lives on hard or an unlock. And you can go to the bosses after that, but you don't get an achievement or an unlock for it. I gotcha. You know, I have a funny feeling about this wall, and I can blow this thing up at the same time, so I want to try. Nope. My funny feeling was not a good feeling. I mean, I'm probably going to try to get all the red icons on the character sheets anyway, just because that's the kind of person I am, but, yeah, I mean, I'm not going to, like, go crazy trying or anything. Nice. What you got for me, Satan? Oh. Oh, hey, Krampus. You seem a little slow there, fella. Well, that wasn't the same speed as always. Double coal. Great. Man, both items Krampus can drop suck. The coal's dumb, and the Krampus head is dumb. I mean, the Krampus head would be cool, but it takes 6 rooms to charge, and it's just not usually worth it. I could go to the pain room. I'd only lose a soul heart. I have plenty of health. Oh yeah, that is pretty obnoxious, Oxbow. I agree. Oh wait. I just bombed my way in there. I should have thought of that 1 million years ago. Oh, well, that's a crappy room anyway. God, I hate fighting spiders in these rooms because you can't fucking see them. Like, you'd think they wouldn't be that hard to see, but like, with the red blood on the floor... And, you know, they're flashing red, so you'd think they would be visible, but they still kind of just blend in with everything. Oh, it's still a 3-room charge on the PS4. That's cool. Yeah, I didn't unlock Krampus's head until after they already fixed that, I guess. Or fix, in quotes. Patch that. Because, Krampus's head always took 6 when I unlocked it. I mean, it's not the worst thing in the world, but there's so many better items you could have instead, you know? Hey! Bag of stuff. I'll take it. I like stuff. Eh. Oh wait. Shit, I didn't want that. God damn it. Well, at least it's still early in the run. There's still a chance to get more hearts. Shit. Oh well, one step closer to getting Guppy, I guess. I got a little overzealous going for those red chests. I should probably be a little bit more careful. Dang, actually got a little bit of slowdown there. I think it just makes stuff drop more often, Oxbow. It's like the sack of pennies, or the sack of bombs, except that it can make any pickup drop more frequently. Satan deals for free. That doesn't work if you have soul hearts, does it? Because even if I had 0 red hearts, Satan deals would still cost soul hearts, right? Hey! Yeah, that's what I thought. A little kitty cat just drops random items, which should be useful for hard mode run because it seems like items drop much less frequently. As definitely now that I've played a hard mode run, a significant amount, you can definitely tell that stuff drops less just in general. Oh, more options would be nice. I'm not going to take the pill bottle since I have the crystal ball. Eh, if I get 10 more coins, I'll come back for more options. Yeah, Trace, I decided to mix things up a little bit and do a hard Eden run instead of doing a Kane or Maggie run or something boring like that. You know, I had a couple Eden tokens lying around, so I wanted to make use of them. You jerk. Didn't even see that spider spawn. Amnesia! Well, there are worse pills you can get, I guess. Hey! Monster manual. They fixed that because didn't it used to say Monster Manuel? M-A-N-U-E-L in the original? Seem to remember that. Wait. I thought that was supposed to give me a familiar. Weird. Oh well. Not better than the crystal ball. It still kind of bothers me that they call it the Book of Revelations, because in the Bible it's actually the Book of Revelation. It's not plural, which I don't know why. That's a very nitpicky thing to care about, but just one of those things that makes me say, Hello, my name is Monster Manuel. Well, I have no idea if there's anything I'm missing because I don't have a map and I don't really care. Nice! I always like getting the slowdown effect on a boss. That was probably a little bit racist, that fake accent thing I just did. I apologize. Nice. Damage. I mean, I wasn't trying to be racist, but it might have come across that way. Well, I guess I'm done. I'm gonna get a, get another heart out of it. Which is nice. Getting the 9 lives might not end up being a total disaster. Yeah, that's true, Expo. Of course, it could always backfire on you and give you a faster boss, too. So, something you have to be mindful of. Three bombs to get a normal brown ass chest, huh? Boy, let me get in line for that deal. I haven't gotten any flying items in the past several runs. Just kind of, it's kind of unusual. I usually get them a little more frequently than that. I have Fate unlocked, so that might be popping up. See how I dropped two keys instead of just the one that normally drops? That's because the bag dropped one. So that's what that does. It just drops stuff. Better chances of devil rooms. Oh, really? Wait, I got the pentagram, not the mark, right? Or does the pentagram have that effect as well? I mean, it makes sense. Oh, shit. It makes sense that more deviled demonic items give you a better chance of getting devil rooms. I just thought the idea of a Spanish or Mexican person named Monster Manuel was pretty funny. That's all. There is a better chance of double rooms with the pentagram. Well, that's cool. Nice. Those are some cool brown chests. I approve. God, all these champion maggots. I can definitely see the hard mode now. Because, I mean, the one time I tried to play on hard, I died pretty quickly. I think I died in the basement, but I just wrote it off to a normal bad run. The mark is a 666 looking thing. Yeah, I can never keep the double item straight. Like, I always get Spirit of the Night mixed up with Lord of the Pit and, you know, all those magic cards. Sister Maggie, eh? Well. Okay. You're mourning the Lord of the Pit that I couldn't get. Yeah, Lord of the Pit would be a fun one to have. Okay. So this... I don't know what this does. Charge with blood. So, I'm assuming that means that items charge faster when I get hit. But isn't that what the habit does? Like, I thought... I'm not sure. There's a difference between the item I just got and the habit, then let me know. I should grab either. Well, I'm very stingy with my hearts, Oxbow. Charges your space item when you press space, but costs blood. Okay. So, like, if I use this, or if I try to use this now. No? My item button, it's not doing anything. Oh, does it have to be, like, completely depleted? And does it just instantly charge it? Because that would be broken if that was the case. Flying civilization. Yeah, I know Oxbow, but I still get into some pretty bad situations, even when I'm flying, if I don't have much health. Range up, nice. Alright, so I use this now. Hit the item button again. And it completely charges it, wow. But it takes a whole heart. Right? Oh, it takes two hearts. Oh, Jesus. Okay, that's not worth it. Crap. I should have been paying closer attention. I wonder if I had, like, Book of Shadows or something. Well, no, that's a bad example. I wonder if I had, like, the Polaroid or something. Something that gave me a shield. If I could just sit here and spam that over and over again until the shield runs out. It seems like they fixed a lot of the instances in the game, in the original game, where you could do that, do stuff like that. Just spam items over and over again and stuff. Meh. Well, at least I know how that works now, even if I didn't lose a ton of health in the process. Oh, didn't even realize he was slow. Probably should have saved my death card. First time I saw Mega Maw, I thought it said Mega Man. Like in that font. I almost just said Mega Man again. Oh, that's helpful. That is very cool. Okay. What you got for me, Angel? Ooh. Now, if I can use that... Trying to figure out if there's a way I can get, like, an infinite item combo going, but I don't think so. Oh well. I don't think I want to be fighting Mega Satan on this run, so I'll leave the Angel alone for now. I can still greed farm? Not sure what that means. Is there a way to farm when you fight greed? Alright, now I can use that. I can use my card again to take 2 hearts of damage. And then, see, I could. I don't know. Yeah, I don't think this is going to really work to my advantage. I mean, I'm glad I got the prayer card because that's a really cool item. Is there any point to killing Mega Satan more than once? Well, technically, there's really no point to killing him once because he doesn't unlock anything. He doesn't give you the icon on your character sheet. The only thing he gives you is ending number 16. So yeah, I mean, there's really no point in fighting him more than once. I mean, I'm probably going to just try to show him off during a stream. Hey! But yeah, for normal purposes, there's really no reason to fight him twice. Kill Grebe, leave an ad in the room, and reset the run, and he will respawn, and the money he dropped stays on the ground. Oh, you mean like one of the enemies that he drops? Okay, I get you. That's cool. That's kind of an exploit that I wouldn't really take advantage of. Now, I mean, if it's a combo in the game that's broken, I take advantage of that all the time because that's in the game, you know. I mean, I guess technically, your trick is still in the game. It's just you kind of have to. It's kind of a weird loophole you have to work around. See, I could trade 2 soul hearts for an extra heart right now, which is basically what the soul converter does. So, you know, why not? Showering me with angel rooms, yeah. Game's being pretty nice. My tears are still pretty regrettable though. Dang. Well, I have plenty of keys, so. So wait, does passing on devil items actually have an effect? Or are you just saying, is that just like a funny coincidence or something? Man, that's the thing that gives you 4 shots, right? But it makes your shot speed way lower. Yeah, Holy Grail or Dead Dove, those would both be pretty nice. I don't know. I mean, it's kind of. I don't know. It's kind of a wash, really. Because, yeah, I mean, you have way more projectiles, but. I don't know. I guess having 4 shots is pretty good. It's not as satisfying. Like, I really like having just a million projectiles coming out of me. You know, a million PPS projectiles per second. It's why I really like soy milk, even though it kind of sucks. Because I just love having billions of projectiles coming out of me. Even though technically this is doing more damage, it's not as satisfying, you know? It's not as, it's not as visceral. Yeah, and I can always get my tears up again, that's true. It does increase the chance for angel runes, really. I had no idea. That's one of those really obscure systems that you would probably never know about if you didn't look it up. Oh, lost my prayer heart. Oh well. Well, now's my chance to test what Little Kitty Cat was talking about. I want to do it at least once just to watch it in action. Yep. Oh, Super Ree this time. Even better. That's a fun trick. I mean, yeah, it's a little cheap, but it gets results. Can't argue with that. Get out of there. Yeah, exactly, Oxbow. Like, I still have no idea what the Sin Meter is. Are Sin and Evil the same thing, or are they two different stats? I have no idea. And if they're not the same thing, shit. If they're not the same thing, then what the hell does Sin do? Wow, that's a lot of stuff. I mean, I get my two bombs back, so I'd say this is worth it. So if Evil and Sin are just the same thing, then why do they have two different names for it? I don't get it. I don't understand you sometimes, Edmund. Okay, I'm glad I got the quad shot. This is definitely working in my favor. Even if it's not as satisfying. Sometimes you just have to eat your vegetables, you know? It's like the soy milk, that's the candy. Because, hey, my damage is horrible, but look at all these projectiles. It's like empty calories. But the quad shot, that's the vegetables. It's good for you. Oh man, stuff is faster. You can tell because of the music. Doesn't happen very often. Sin ups the chance of devil rooms and sin hearts dropping in place of red soul hearts. Okay. And evil's the same thing. So when it says evil up and sin up, those are the same exact effect. I mean, it's a really obtuse system. But I mean, I guess that's why I like this game, is because it has stuff to discover, stuff to figure out. Even though, I mean, with stuff like that though, shit. Like I was saying, you would never know about any of that stuff if you don't look it up on the wiki. That's the kind of discovery I'm not a fan of, you know? Yeah, how can you have any pudding if you don't eat your meat? Exactly. How can you have any soy milk if you don't get bitten by a mutant spider? It's the same thing. Bad trip, really? Oh well, at least it didn't affect my eternal heart. Nice. Definitely coming back from getting the 9 lives thing. Evil and Sin helps for a soul heart build. Yeah, I can definitely see that. No, my blood machine. Oh, well. There's not that many hearts on the slope. Ooh. God, the game's being nice to me. I should play on hard mode more often. Shit. Look at them stats. Thanks, little kitty cat. Someone put that line on a t-shirt. Trade 2 keys or 4 bombs. I'd say that's worth it. since I have enough keys. Oh, the sharp plug prayer card. Yeah, I guess I could do that again. Get another heart since I have two soul hearts. Well, one and a half. Okay, I need to go somewhere. I can stand still and look at my map. I mean, there are plenty of places the secret room could be. I don't really want to go hunting for it. I don't like the cage. I don't understand why he's called the cage. Like, I guess because he has enemies inside him. I mean, he doesn't look like a cage. And like a lot of bosses have enemies inside them, so that's not really a good enough justification on its own. Nice. Oh, wait. Oh. Duh. I got two item rooms. Of course this is an XL level. I am so good at paying attention. Yeah, the cage sucks. Alright, so that means this is going to be Mom, right? Is there anything else I want to do here? The chest over there I didn't get. Which means it's probably not worth it. There's a pain room. But, eh. I mean, I could go... I mean, hell, I could... go after these hearts and make use of my prayer card that way. Well, I can't charge it at the moment. But, I guess I might as well get this. I have enough stuff. And I'm about to not need keys anymore anyway. Kind of sucks that an item has to be completely depleted before you can charge it that way. I should be able to just hit the button and... I mean, it's a worse deal for me because... you know, it's less juice for the same price. Check the curse room. Yeah, I guess I could. Well, I got my soul heart back. That's like when you buy one of those dumb scratch-off lottery tickets that no one should ever buy, and you pay a dollar for it, and you just win a dollar. It's like that. Hey, I made my dollar back. You still feel good even though you didn't really get anything. Yeah, sacrifice rooms have always been terrible. I don't understand them. That's okay, Oxbow. Whoa. What version of Mom is this? Oh, she's slow, okay. I was like, wait, I haven't seen this color of Mom before. Man, I am getting super lucky with the slow effect. I've gotten like three slow bosses out of it. And man, getting it on Mom, that's just the best. So wait, is there an achievement for beating Mom's heart on hard with every character? Or do you just have to do it? Hmm. Because if it's with every character, then... that gives me a reason to play the game a lot more. Shit. Alright, well, I might as well use this now because there's no point in clearing a bunch of rooms and not getting anything out of it. Even though I'm probably going to get hit, it's still a free hit, you know? Even if I don't get the extra heart out of it. And it's better than walking around with a fully charged prayer card. Each character has a baby unlocked for co-op, really? Well, that's cool. actually thought the co-op options were a little bit lacking. So it's nice to know there's more co-op stuff you can unlock. I wonder how this interacts with the mutant spider thing. That's kind of cool. I like it. I think I'll take that. I mean, I have 9 lives, so it's not like this is ever going to happen, or probably never going to happen. That's all you need to do for Platinum God on hard mode. Yeah, but Platinum God isn't really Platinum God in this version. You have to get the real Platinum God. It's a fun that could also ruin friendships. I mean, I've done some co-op, and I never really felt like the person I was doing co-op with and I had any, like, you know, there was no strain on our relationship or anything. Or, I don't know, maybe Morse hates me now. You never know. But I don't think so. Jesus Christ! Oh. Holy crap, look at the size of this hollow. Shit. I've never seen one that huge before. I was so awestruck that I got hit by him. May have an actual chance at Platinum God. That's cool. I got Platinum God in the original Binding of Isaac, but that's only because you don't need the no damage achievements. Like, to get the real Platinum God, I'm going to have to, shit, I wonder if I can get this guy out without killing him. Probably not. But I mean, to get the real Platinum God, I'm gonna have to do shit as the Lost. And forget that. Oh, that's cool. It's a pretty good drop to get from that guy, I guess. Clear the chest without taking damage. Yeah, good luck. Wait, how do I get? Oh, I guess it must like wrap around over there, because there's no way to get to the other secret room from this side. I don't know, having shots go that far and that fast is pretty satisfying too, even if I don't get to do it a lot. You need to kill both Isaac and Satan with the Lost on normal to unlock Platinum for PS4. Just the regular Platinum? Not the real Platinum God? Because if that's the case, that sucks. Did they change that on PC or something? Jesus! Yeah, me either. I do not see myself pulling that off anytime soon. Of course, I've surprised myself before, so you never know. I mean, really, all it comes down to is how many hundreds of hours I want to put into this game. Because, I mean, like I said, all you need with the Lost is the non-leaf and a bunch of stuff that does damage passively. Okay, so I'm going to clear one more room, then come back and get this, and immediately get a heart. Okay, cool. Because, I mean, I'm pretty sure if you get that combo, there's nothing stopping you. I mean, it'll be boring as hell, because all you're going to be doing is just standing around in every room waiting for stuff to die. But it's feasible. Okay. So I guess I'm done. What's this chest up here? Oh yeah, I can't get to that. I mean, I have kind of a lot of bombs. I guess I could, well, shit, I don't know. Oh hey. I like this guy because he gives me a pony. Ooh, I'd have to give up my card to get the pony though. Shit. I guess I can give up the heart, the card of this stage. I have plenty of hearts. Ooh, another guppy item. Nice. Oh shit. Oh man. Well. Alright, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna do that. And that. And then take the pony with me. That's the best strategy, I think. Yeah. Okay. Feel kind of bad about spending two normal hearts to only get five soul hearts instead of six, but in the end, I think it'll be okay. Yeah, I probably should have held on to the Paul kitty cat. Oh well. I couldn't pass up the ability to fly, you know? I just can't pass it up. Especially since I've hardly had any runs during streams where I get flying items. Screw, damn it! I didn't want to charge. I just wanted rays of light to come down from the sky and kill everything. But even that didn't happen. Hi, Mom. Oh, thank you. I will gladly take a soul heart. Oh God. Oh shit. Got myself kind of cornered there. God, that guy took a lot of hits to die. Okie doke. Oh, he's slow. That's nice. Shit. I need to stop leaving my map up like that. Cause I didn't even know there was a spider over here. I only saw this one. Oops. Shit! There I go. Not looking where I'm going when I enter a damn room. Come on, soul hearts. Or guppy item, but I doubt you're gonna give me that. I guess theoretically. These things drop chests sometimes, right? You drop a red chest that has a guppy item in it. Stranger things have happened. Should have charged those eyeballs when I used that. I always forget about the charge effect. Like, I remember the beam of light effect, but I forget that it charges as well. I always think that's just the other pony. Yeah, I should have kept the paw. Shit. Oh well. Glitch baby. That sounds like fun. Never seen a red chest drop from the fortune teller. Yeah, I might be making that up. I don't know, maybe if he had like the left hand or something, it'd be more likely to happen. I don't know. Oh shit. I don't know what that was. I kind of said shit and crap at the same time. I was like, shrap. I don't like Daddy Long Legs when he's not on my side. Shit. Well. I don't know. It doesn't seem that much faster, really, with cancer. I guess my base shot speed isn't high enough for it to have that much of an effect. I'd rather have the whipworm. Thank you. So even if I die in the cathedral, I will have still made progress. I will have accomplished something. Oh yeah, that's right, I have 9 lives. Shit, well, this will be a long, painful, dragged out loss. I mean, I really don't like having 9 lives because spawning back with 1 heart, all it does is make the game more annoying. Because, I mean, what am I going to do with 1 heart? The only reason I ever pick up 9 lives is if I already only have 1 or 2 hearts. Or if I wanted to get to become Guppy. Like, I don't like it otherwise. Like, I only picked it up by accident this time. I mean, it worked out for me for a while because I got a ton of health, but wasn't enough to keep me alive. Damn, I should have kept the paw. Drum would have gone way different for me. Yeah, fixated on the flight. Come on, health. Maybe this guy will drop a red chest that has a guppy item. Reusable knockback. Well, that's not better than a pony. I can still recover. Well, thanks for your confidence. I will try not to let you down. Shit. Nope. Shit. I should just try to bomb my way to the boss. Oh my god, those projectiles were so fast. Oh right. That sucks. I wonder if they're still going to be sped up when I go back in there. I don't think so. I think the speed effect will reset. Yeah. Man, it'd be pretty cool if I if I got to fight a slowed down Isaac. I don't think I'll be that lucky though. Jesus Christ, these guys. Well, I guess they are mini bosses. They're just. I was gonna say they're just taking forever to die. But. I guess that makes sense. Crap. I wonder if I can just bomb my way in there. Yeah, I wasn't sure if that would work or not. You know, some, like, some orbital flies would be pretty nice. Give me a little projectile protection. Hey, there's one. Ask and ye shall receive. Not sure if it works on Isaac and the Blue Baby. Yeah, probably not. Man, all these hearts. I can't do anything with them. Well, crap. So we'll have to fight these guys eventually, I guess. Unless I want to continue trying to bomb my way through here, but... that's probably not going to work. Man, I don't know where this run went wrong. I mean, I was doing pretty well. I just, I just took too many hits. Sometimes that's all it comes down to. I mean, you can get some good items, and you just lose because you take too many hits, and that's it. That's fate. The hell away from me. Oh, it does work on Isaac and the Blue Baby. That's good. Because those fights would be significantly easier. Man, screw this. I'm not going to fight Monstro 2 for no reason. Doesn't even go anywhere. Yeah, that's true, Oxbow. Even if I do fail at this point, I still beat It Lives on hard. I'm just looking for, like, big clusters of rocks I can bomb or anything. Just to give myself any edge I can get, you know. Oh, I killed one of them already? Huh. That's fast. You know, my first hard mode win. I feel pretty good about that. I mean, win, in quotation marks, I guess. Speed up? Okay. Well, this shouldn't be too hard since I can fly. Should be pretty easy to give these guys a slip. Alright, time to start bombing erratically, I guess. Well, there's a secret room over here I should definitely get. Sweet. God, how many Lokis are you gonna make me fight, game? At least it's just Loki and not Loki. Because I don't want to have to fight four of these things. Alright, here it goes. Going in there. Oh, shit. I'm fighting Isaac. I'm really gonna do it. Watch me go fight Isaac. That's definitely a thing that I'm doing. Oh, shit. Why did I... Oh, man. That was a very poor decision. Shit. For fuck's sake. I don't know why I thought I'd been in there. Is it even possible to get one of those black markets in the cathedral? It would be really cool if I could just like skip straight to the chest. Thanks, Oxbow. Shit. Shit. Not react quickly enough. All right. Now's your chance, Isaac. If you want to be slow, help me out. Possible but unlikely. Yeah, you're probably right. Just like Isaac being slow is possible but unlikely. And yeah, I tried three times to slow him down, and I had a 0% success rate, so... Oh god. I charged right into his laser beam. I shouldn't have tried to use my laser beam at the same time that he did. That was a bad idea. But hey! Red outline. Pretty fancy, am I right, guys? Pretty fancy. Alright, well. This has been... Yeah, I know, Oxbow. I shouldn't have tried to do that. This has been the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. I hope you all had a good time. I know I had a good time, had a couple successful runs, so I'm feeling pretty good about tonight's stream. And I look forward to doing this again sometime soon. Not sure when. I do want to stream some different games too, just to mix things up a little bit. But, you know, watch the Twitter and whatever social media you use. I'm there probably for updates about when I stream again. Good try from One Heart. Thank you. Yeah, I just felt like, well, like I said, I don't know where that run started going downhill, but I had a good time. Anyway, see y'all soon. Night, everyone.